Hey guys, in this video we will build the following sales page from scratch using Python and a bit of CSS. On the website you could sell your digital products like in my example here. The first section will briefly describe the product. Additionally, we will implement this animated call to action button. If you click on it, you will be redirected to the checkout form to handle the payment process. In the next section, you can give the potential buyer more context by listing down the main features. Optionally, you could also embed a video as I did here. Next, we will have a FAQ section where the visitor can click on a question to see the answer. And last but not least, we will also insert a fully functional contact form. This website is also live on the internet, so feel free to check it out. You can find the link in the description. Okay, and without further ado, let us get started. Before coding out the website, let us take care of the payment processing. One good solution is Stripe. Just head over to stripe.com and set up an account. Once you have an account, navigate to your dashboard. Inside the dashboard, click on Payments and then navigate to Payment Links. To create a new payment link, click on New in the upper corner. On the left side, you can now enter your details, and next to it, you can see a preview of how the checkout form will look like. To get started, click on Add a new product. Here you would enter your product name and description. For the sake of this tutorial, I will simply ask for a coffee donation and set the price to 2 euro. Optionally, you could also insert an image. Once you have added the product, you might also want to check the other options. For me, I will leave the default settings and switch over to the confirmation page. Now, when someone buys your product, you also want to provide the customer with the download link. However, in my case, I will write a simple thank you message. Keep in mind that I have kept things simple here. You could, of course, also use the Stripe API to process a payment and set up your own backend API to send confirmation emails to your customers and so on. If you're interested in a more advanced solution, let me know in the comments. With that said, let me create the payment link by clicking the following button. Afterwards, I will copy this URL to my clipboard and navigate to that site. So this is how the checkout form will look like. Okay, and with that preparation in place, let us code out the website. First things first, you need to install Streamlit. Therefore, spin up your terminal or command prompt, type pip install streamlit and pillow, and hit enter. Besides Streamlit, we will also need pillow to insert images into our web application. Once you have that out of the way, let us set up the project files. On my desktop, I have already prepared an empty folder. Inside this folder, I will create another folder and name it Assets. Inside the Assets directory, I will dump all images for the website. For now, I will only paste one photo here called product.png. In addition to the Assets directory, I will also create a Styles folder. And within the Styles directory, I will create a new file called main.css. I will leave the file empty for now, but we will return to this file later in the video to style our web page. Alright, and finally, I will create the actual Python file and name it streamlit_app.py. Open this file with your preferred text editor. As a first step, I will import the dependencies. To deal with the different file paths, I will import path from pathlib. Pathlib is a core Python module, therefore you do not need to install it. Next, I will import Streamlit as st, and from pill, I will import image. With our imports in place, let us now set the paths to the different folders we have created. As a starting point, I want to get the file path to the current directory, so the directory where this Python file is located. To get this path, we can use the pathlib module and take the parent directory of the current file. If that is not available, we can get the current directory using path.cwd. With that in place, we can now construct the other file paths. So inside this directory, we have the assets and styles folder. And within the styles folder, we can also find our main.css file. The only thing missing is the product image in the assets folder, but we will take care of that in just a moment. Next, let me set up some general settings. Within this section, we will define some product-related information, like the Stripe checkout link we generated at the beginning of the video. Next, I will also write down the contact email address. So you want to replace this with your email address. After that, I will provide a product name, tagline, and description. So this will be the information I plan to insert at the very top of our website. Notice that within the product description, you can also use Markdown. So the dashes will be later converted to bullet points, and to make the last sentence bold, I have inserted two asterisks at the beginning and end. In the next part, let us set up some basic configurations. To do so, type st.setPageConfig, and then you can specify the page title, page icon, layout, and sidebar status. For the page title, I will use the product name which we have already defined. For the page icon, you can also use emojis as I did here. A great website to find the shortcode of any emoji is the following page. I will also leave the link to this webpage in the description. For the layout, you can choose between wide and centered. And by default, Streamlit should collapse the sidebar. Alright, now after all the settings, let us start coding out the main section. As a reference, let me show an image of how this section should look like. First, we have a header with the product name. Right below that, we have a subheader with the product tagline. After that, we have two columns. The left column is twice as big as the right one. To achieve this in Streamlit, you can write it as follows. Within the left column, I will first insert a blank line to add some padding. Afterwards, we can insert the product description. Now, on the final page, we have a button to navigate to the checkout page. There's also a Streamlit button available, but I would like to create a custom button to change the color and add a cool animation effect. Therefore, I'm using a little hack here. For now, I will simply insert an HTML link using the Markdown element. Inside the HTML link, I will insert the Stripe checkout link and assign it to the button class. You also want to set unsafe allow HTML to true. Okay, and in the right column, we will place our product image. First, we need to open the image using Pillow. In our case, the image is located in the assets folder and is named product.png. To display it, you can type st.image followed by the image object. Optionally, you could also set the width. Alright, and before going further, let us check out how our website looks. Therefore, go back to your terminal. Ensure that you are in the correct directory. In my case, the project is located on my desktop and the folder is called sales page. To spin up your website, you need to type streamlit1 followed by the name of the Python file. After pressing enter, Streamlit will open the website in your default browser. I am using Chrome in dark mode, and therefore my website has a black background and white font. In your case, it might be the opposite, so a white background with a black font. But do not worry, we have to change the styling later on anyways. For now, let us focus on the content of the website. So here we can see the page title and icon, the header, the subheader, and our two columns. For now, we only have a link to our checkout page and not an actual button. But as I said, we will take care of that later in the video. However, we could test the link already by clicking on it. Alright, and this seems to be working. We can now see the checkout page. Now, I assume in many cases, you might want to give the potential buyer a bit more context about your product. Therefore, in the next section, we will list some features of your product. Before coding out that section, let me add a couple of more images to the assets folder. I have named those pictures feature 1, feature 2, and feature 3. Of course, you could also use any other image or icons instead of those screenshots. Back in the script, I will create a new section. To add some vertical space, I use an empty right element, followed by a divider, and a subheader. As before, you can also use emoji in the subheader as I did here. Okay, and for the features, there are 3 main elements. An image, a heading, and the actual description. Before inserting those elements, I will create a dictionary containing all the information for those elements. The structure will be as follows. First, I'm using the image name as the dictionary's key. The value for that key will be a list. Inside that list, I will place 2 elements. The first one will be the header, and then I will explain the feature in more detail. You can do this for as many features as you want. Once you have that dictionary, you can loop over it. So let me make some space, and then I will write for image and description in features.items. For each iteration, I will first load the image. Then I used another vertical space before creating two columns. In the left column, I will place the image, which should have the same width as the entire column. In the right column, I will insert the title. But in fact, the title shouldn't be too large. So I'm simply making the font bold using some markdown. We can get the title by accessing the first item of the list, so at index position 0. Below that, we will place the actual description, which we can find at index position 1. And that is all there is to it. After saving the file, let me navigate back to the website and give it a refresh. As a result, we can now see the features. As I said, feel free to use icons instead of screenshots or add even more features. The next section will be optional, depending on whether you want to insert a video on your website or not. In case you have a short demo video of your product, you can also insert it using Streamlit. To do so, I will create a new variable at the top with the link to the demo video. Next, I will create a new section and use an empty white element, divider and subheader again. Placing the actual video on the website is very straightforward. Simply type st.video followed by the link and format. Optionally, you could also define the start time. Once you save the file, you can go back to your website. When I refresh the website and scroll down a bit, we can see that we have now embedded the video. Okay, and with that, let us move on and insert a FAQ section. This will also be very similar to before. This time, I will create another dictionary, where the key is the question, and the value will be the answer. Once we have that, I will loop over the dictionary and display the question in the expander element. Inside the expander, I will insert the answer. And that is all there is to it. So, when we switch back to our site and reload it, we now have our FAQ section where the user can click on the question to see the answer. Okay, and with that we are almost done. Perhaps your website visitor might still have an open question after reading the FAQ section. Therefore, we will also insert a contact form onto our page. Now, I already have a full tutorial on creating a contact form in Streamlit. You can find the video under the following link or in the info card above. I would encourage you to watch that video to understand how it works, as I will not explain the details in this video. Essentially, we are placing an HTML form in Streamlit using a markdown element. To receive the message, we will use the free service from Form Submit. With that, let me save the file again and refresh the website. At the bottom of the site, we can now see the contact form, but without any styling, it doesn't look very appealing. To change this and to convert the link to the checkout page to an actual button, we will need to write some custom CSS. To do so, we have already created an empty CSS file in the styles folder. In this file now, I will paste some pre-written CSS code. You can also find the final CSS file on GitHub, so you could simply copy and paste the code from there. In the first part, I'm taking care of the button class, like defining the color and size. Additionally, I have added the bouncing animation down here. Next, let me also paste the CSS code for the contact form. Last but not least, I will also hide the Streamlit branding by setting the main menu, footer and header visibility to hidden. Now that we have our CSS file, we need to inject it somehow into our website. For this, let me switch back to our script and make some space before our page configurations. Here I will insert a function that takes a file path as an input. And then I will open the file and return its content in a markdown element. You want to make sure to place the content between the style tags and set unsafe allow HTML to true. Now that we have that function, we just need to execute it. And I will do this right after our page settings. So I will type a load CSS file followed by the CSS file path. To see the changes, navigate to your website and refresh it. Alright, and this seems to be working. Our link now looks like an actual button and we have this cool bouncing effect. If you click on it, we will be still redirected to the checkout page. And if you scroll down to the contact form, we can see that this looks much better now. Okay, and for the final touch, we can also use the Streamlit theme feature. To do so, you want to create a new directory. The name of this folder should be .streamlit. Inside this directory, create yet another file and name it config.toml. Open the file with your preferred text editor. Here you can now create a new section called theme. And within the theme section, you can set, for example, the different colors for the background, the elements, and the font. In my case, I am going for a white theme. When you save the file and refresh your website, nothing will happen. To apply the changes, you need to restart your Streamlit session by pressing Ctrl and C in your terminal. Afterwards, I will restart the server. Alright guys, and this is what our final site looks like. For now, this website is only available on your machine. To deploy the website to the internet, you could use the Streamlit Community Cloud or any other hosting service. I already created a video on deploying a Streamlit site like this to render. You can find the link to the video in the info card above and also in the description. As always, thanks for watching and see you in the next video.